Charges laid against an 18-year-old woman at the centre of the Katoni Stags revenge porn scandal. Flick past faux pas, the dressing room antics that have landed AFL players in a world of hurt.
And our week-long tour of Queensland comes to a very soggy end. Your weather good to go from the beautiful scenic rim. We'll have all those details coming up shortly.
This is 10 News First Queensland with Georgina Lewis.
Good evening. As we go to air tonight, Queensland is just 8 hours from slamming the border shut. The entire east coast will soon be cut off from entering the Sunshine State in a last line of defence to stop a devastating second wave.
In the countdown to our coronavirus closure, another backlog at the border. Queenslanders in a race against the clock to get back before 1 a.m.
How long has it taken you to get up here?
About 45 minutes.
Gotta go.
It's quite a headache, isn't it? A lot of people sort of having a hard time.
It means a lot of inconvenience for a lot of people. I understand that.
For the foreseeable future, this is what it will mean for those who live and work between Queensland and New South Wales. The border bubble includes 72 postcodes from country towns to the coast on either side, including the Tweed Shire. It doesn't incorporate Mullumbimby, Byron Bay or Ballina. People in the approved areas will need a pass, but they can cross for any reason at any time.
They can only come into the adjacent communities on the other side of the border. They can't go through the rest of Queensland.
Residents and businesses that depend on border customers breathing a sigh of relief.
Oh, 100%. As long as there's a good flow for the local residents to come over the border and do business as normal, that's essential.
Anyone else who tries to enter Queensland will have to fly, except for freight supply, critical workers and those with an exemption. Fly-in, fly-out workers and tradies are not considered essential.
For instance, to go and build a house or do a job in Byron Bay, you've gone into the hotspot and you would not be able to come back into Queensland.
They are all about keeping the virus out of Queensland, protecting the lives of Queenslanders.
We are the safe state with just 11 active cases. While the situation in New South Wales is being contained well, our Chief Health Officer is concerned about mystery infections.
Despite that, they're still seeing every single day cases that they can't link back to known outbreaks.
Police are processing a huge amount of people at checkpoints every day. Yesterday alone, more than 6,000 vehicles were checked and 68 people refused entry.
We expect the road borders in particular to be quite problematic over the weekend, and please work with us.
Well, with all these closures and the limited flights now, there'll be no zip-zop-zipping from state to state.
Keeping Queensland just for Queenslanders.
And John Paul joins us now from Coolangatta. JP, how are things there at the moment?
Georgie, traffic is flowing relatively freely at this checkpoint. It is a different story elsewhere, though, on the M1 and the Gold Coast Highway. Delays of more than an hour. People desperate to make it back into Queensland. It will get worse before it gets better, and that is because that new border pass that residents require still isn't online, meaning they cannot apply for it yet. Police say it might not be ready by the 1 a.m. deadline. In that case, officers will have to pull people over on the side of the road to verify their identity and their address. So tonight, it's not just drivers rushing to get through these checkpoints. Authorities are also scrambling to put these new border arrangements in place. Georgie?
Thank you, JP. Live there at Coolangatta. The Story Bridge standoff has today become a stalemate. Refugee advocates have delivered police an ultimatum to avoid the planned protest, and authorities have responded with full force.
A final plea on the eve of a planned protest.
Please do not go and protest this weekend.
Any breach of our health directions could put the lives of Queenslanders at risk.
Police say those pushing ahead with the shutdown of the Story Bridge will be stopped.
They will not be permitted to block the Bradfield Highway, the Story Bridge. We will take action, and if people commit offences, they can expect to be arrested.
But organisers have their own demands. If refugees housed in the Kangaroo Point Hotel are given more freedom, they won't demonstrate.
These men inside have been locked here for 12 to 18 months. They aren't able to move around outside at all. They aren't able to see their families or be into the community at all.
Tomorrow's action coming at a critical time for Queensland.
It's too soon to relax. It's far too soon.
Five cases have now been linked to the Logan trio who travelled to Melbourne. Since then, almost 120,000 people heeded the warning to get checked. Just in the past 24 hours, 16,000 tests were all negative.
To do all of that and potentially have it undone because people breach those requirements this weekend would be an awful thing to see.
I believe that social distancing and safety requirements will be followed. I would say that there is a football game just on down the road that will be on at the same time, where 10,000 people will be assembling, and will be a similar COVID risk there.
If large crowds gather tomorrow and there is a potential outbreak, the Chief Health Officer warns she may have to reconsider the easing of restrictions around aged care facilities.
That's what's at stake here, whether hundreds of Queenslanders can have their families visit them in their nursing homes or not.
Claire Barnes for 10 News First.
An extra $15 billion will be injected into the JobKeeper scheme. The federal government has delivered the funding along with two major adjustments to eligibility criteria.
With the economy on life support, today the Treasurer extended another helping hand, adding $15 billion to the JobKeeper subsidy.
The single largest economic support package that any Australian government has ever undertaken.
And relaxing the eligibility to support more Australians. From September 28, businesses will only need to show a downturn for the September quarter compared to a similar period in 2019. And if you're applying for JobKeeper from January, you'll only need to show a fall in turnover for the December quarter. Employees eligible must be on the books as of the 1st of July this year, because
some businesses, as they were opening up and progress was made on the health front, they took on new employees. Those employees will now be eligible for JobKeeper.
Treasury indicates 4 million Australians will be on JobKeeper during the September quarter. Of those, 1.3 million will be in Victoria.
That's nearly half the private sector workforce in Victoria.
It's estimated 400,000 more Australians will lose their jobs between now and Christmas. This has prompted a warning from the Reserve Bank of Australia that without continued economic support from the government, Australia faces a long-term unemployment crisis.
The key test for the Morrison government is whether they can prevent those unemployment queues being too long.
The JobKeeper bill will now hit $101 billion. Payments will be scaled back from the end of September from $1,500 a fortnight to $1,200 to keep the scheme going as long as possible.
JobKeeper has been a lifeline to people's livelihoods. It's been a lifeline to businesses.
A lifeline that will eventually have to end.
For more on this, Stella Todorovic joins us live from Parliament House. Stella, why now?
Well, Georgie, Victoria's lockdown is really hurting the national economy. As we found out yesterday, the price tag on these latest restrictions in Victoria is around $12 billion. And this is really why the government has moved quickly overnight to extend JobKeeper to as many Australians as possible. And while this is mostly targeted at helping Victorians who have been left devastated by the restrictions, it is a national program. The government today emphasising that every business can apply and to see if they're eligible.
Thank you, Stella. Live there in Canberra. Australians stuck in Beirut are desperately trying to find their way home, but they've told 10 News First the Australian government isn't offering much help as the situation on the ground gets more precarious.
Shock has given way to desperation. French President Emmanuel Macron vows to help. Lebanon is a former French colony. Here the crowd hangs on his every word, given there's so little faith in their own government.
La confiance et l'espoir.
Macron said an international inquiry into the blast is needed, also an audit of the Lebanese Central Bank, as the economy was already in ruins and its currency free-falling before the explosion. Next stop from desperation is overwhelming pain. The Lebanese start to bury the more than 137 killed. Bedside vigils for thousands injured, like this seven-year-old boy.
I just want to live and stay in a place where there's no politics, there's no guns, there's no religion.
I can't forget the explosion, the sound, the visuals in front of my eyes. Wow,
And I literally saw body parts of people thrown in the main road. People screaming, kids screaming, body parts. I saw a hand, I saw two legs.
Pain quickly descends into anger. Protesters demanding the government pick up the pieces, both of the city and the political system, after years of corruption and inaction, and growing evidence officials knew the material was dangerous and refused to do anything about it. Australian family the Mooses were at home in downtown Beirut, the kids playing in this room, when the blast wave knocked them to the ground.
This is the couch where the kids were sitting. This is the glass that would have flown at them. You can see the blood on the floor from the children. They were cut by glass.
Their home is unlivable.
Everything's just broken.
The kids escaped serious injury but have recurring nightmares.
Despite some governments expatriating their citizens, the Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade has said because of COVID-19 they won't be sending any planes to Beirut. Instead, they suggest Australians book commercial flights home, even though there aren't any available for weeks.
So for now, the nightmare continues. Antoinette Latouf for 10 News First.
Police have charged a woman allegedly behind the release of a revenge porn video involving Brisbane Broncos star Katoni Staggs. Brendan Savage joins us now. Brendan, this is headed to court.
Yes, Georgie, 18-year-old Mackenzie Robinson has been served with a notice to appear after being charged with distributing a prohibited visual recording. It's alleged the Newstead woman used her phone to record a sexual encounter with the 21-year-old Broncos center and later leaked the footage online after he stopped responding to her calls and text messages. Mr. Staggs made a complaint to police after the video began circulating on social media. He provided a detailed statement and handed over an exchange of Instagram messages. Mr. Staggs is extremely embarrassed and disappointed that his private life has been brought into the public domain. He is hoping to put this behind him now and leave it with the authorities. The NRL Integrity Unit has cleared Mr. Staggs to play in tonight's clash with South Sydney. Georgie, the matter is due to be heard in the Brisbane Magistrates Court next month.
Thank you, Brendan, with that update. Coming up, the desperate mission to put the brakes on one of Queensland's most deadly addictions. Also, rain aplenty. Josh is live as the heavens open over the southeast. Plus, drive-through Dagwood dogs, a new era for the Ecker. And in sport, the Broncos embroiled in their own COVID controversy as a club legend is forced into quarantine.
Animated film. I love it. Love it. Perfect.
Don't show up. Don't come out. It was purring, and I don't want to see you dance with anybody else.
Back off, Dave. I've got 14 of your mates already living with me.
The Masked Singer starts 7:30 Monday.
Hey, Queensland. This is our state. It's vast and incredible. With so much to discover. From the tropics to the coast, the outback to the islands, the cities to the rainforest and reef, from the countryside to the water slides. It's time to explore like never before!
Hey, mate.
Tom, you on your way?
Woohoo! Yeah, mate, good to go!
Let's get out there, Queensland.
At Spotlight, save more at our Homemaker Sale with 50% off all Shaggy rugs. Koo Eloise quilt cover set from $39. Ilna 1000 Sewing Machine VIP price $180. So roll it, make it and sew it for less. Sale on now. At Spotlight, it's what you make it.
I am into this plant-based thing. Might give No Meat Mondays a crack. Just got to figure out what day it is. Peg! Do you know what day it is?
Try the new plant-based range at 7-Eleven.
The great outdoors has never looked better. And to celebrate, Mitsubishi is offering 7 years warranty and up to $1,500 worth of genuine accessories, so you'll be all set to come and see for yourself.
This Saturday, place a fixed odds win bet on all races at Doomben, Rose Hill and Flemington in-venue with your TAB app. And if your horse runs second, third, fourth or fifth, get a bonus bet back up to $50. TAB, long may we play.
If you've been thinking about university, now's the time to get started. But enrolments close on the 23rd of August. Find the right study choice for you, all in one place, with Open Universities Australia. Explore online courses today.
Hi, honey. I've got the pork roast. I'll be home soon.
Riverview Farms pork roast. Perfectly cooked for your family and ready to go, just like Nana made it every time.
I don't expect a girl to jump off buildings for me, but if she jumps into my arms, that's a good start. Nicole has a lot of energy. That's somebody I just want to be around.
The Bachelor starts 7:30 Wednesday.
Well, good afternoon. Some wet conditions as we head into the weekend. A multi-vehicle crash on the Gateway southbound. Two lanes are blocked at the moment after Old Cleveland Road through Belmont. It's got delays pretty much all the way back to Tingalpa and building back towards the bridge pretty quickly. Also, a single-vehicle crash with a pole down on Norwell Road through Wingulba. And Berthwater Main repairs on Nudgee Road have northbound blocked just after the east-west arterial road through Nunda. And that's got delays, pretty much back a couple of hundred metres. And some really heavy going on the Gateway this afternoon from Nudgee to the Bruce. I'm Dave Andrews, thanks to Palm Lake Resort. Georgie, another check coming up a little later in the bulletin.
We'll speak to you again soon. Thanks, Dave. The AFL's defending champions have put up the shutters tonight amid questions over locker room behaviour. Two Tigers stars appear to repeatedly grab the genitals of a teammate. Actions which a senior lawyer today said could amount to serious sexual assault. Here's National Affairs editor Hugh Rimmington.
Nick Vlosten is a Richmond star.
Richmond's number one, Nick Vlosten.
A two-time premiership winner. But after Tuesday's win on the Gold Coast against the Brisbane Lions, the broadcast camera catches him reaching towards teammate Mabior Chol and apparently jamming a finger in his anus. Chol appears shocked. He's no longer clapping along with the team, but instead tries to make distance from Vlosten, only for Vlosten to pepper him with hits to his genitals.
The images are quite disturbing. This is unacceptable, and criminal law in this country should apply.
Lawyers say there is no criminal exemption for footy change rooms.
I was quite affronted by the vision and, frankly, in a technical sense, noting there's a context, that was an assault.
On camera, after Tuesday's game, we counted eight hits to the genitals by Vlosten against Mabior Chol. And just the week before, Chol endured similar treatment from another Premiership teammate, Jaden Short. Chol appears to tell Short to back off, only to cop another flick below the belt.
13 goals.
Former New South Wales Australian of the Year, the criminal lawyer Deng Adut, says the attack on the anus is particularly demeaning in South Sudanese culture.
Everything was unwelcome. The touch were unwelcome. He basically retreated and basically seemed like he was isolated in the team, and he was the only person to be targeted and nobody else.
Richmond coach Damien Hardwick told us via Zoom he had no knowledge of the incident before cutting the conversation short.
Thanks for your questions, Hugh, but we'll move on from that. And if we have any more questions about the football, the game, we'll go from there. Thank you.
Nearly 20 years ago, NRL star John Hopewate was suspended for 12 weeks for similar assaults against opposing players. There were no charges then, but legally charges could come now, even without a complaint from Mario Chong.
Either the police in Queensland or the safety regulator could initiate process around criminal proceedings.
Vlosten, Short and Chol were all training today. Coach Hardwick would not comment on whether all would play against AFL frontrunners Port Adelaide tomorrow.
Now, we have put in requests for responses from the Richmond Football Club management, as well as the AFL chief Gil McLaughlin and the managers for the players involved. So far, nothing. Hugh Rimmington for 10 News First.
Missing jewellery and mysterious bank transfers are at the heart of the manslaughter case against a former NDIS carer. Rosemary Mayoni faced court in Adelaide today, accused of leaving Anne Smith in a chair for more than a year before she died. Prosecutors told the court they believe she also stole $30,000 worth of jewellery, while the victim's $200,000 inheritance is missing. A magistrate will make a decision on whether to grant bail next week. Despite threats of big fines and losing their licence, a shocking number of drivers still admit giving in to their mobile phone addiction. While the deadly distraction is usually associated with youth, more mature drivers are almost as guilty.
Excuses are a bit like that annoying relative. We've all got one.
If you miss something, you might miss out, whether that's an opportunity for a job shift or something happens, you just need to know instantly.
Getting a message from your mum, maybe.
It's basically sitting right next to you, you're getting all these notifications.
Despite so many warnings.
A glance at your phone is the same as this.
Big fines and road cameras that just don't miss. Motorists are still ringing, texting, even video watching while they drive.
You're four times more likely to have a crash if you're using your mobile phone behind the wheel. That's the reality here.
Just as real, an Australian Automobile Association survey which found of the 93% of drivers who tried to break the habit, half of those under 25 failed.
But I refrain, I don't. But yeah, it is tempting.
And it's not just a matter of youth. A third of older drivers surveyed also couldn't resist.
I think you just have to think about, like, the risk of what will happen if you do that.
So now there's yet another approach to breaking through, this time by dealing with the problem like an addiction.
With smoking, with gambling, they first must understand the full extent of the issue and then accept that they have a problem.
This online question and answer survey aims to highlight where drivers attempted most to use their phones and how to stop it.
Road safety experts agree the questionnaire will be a useful tool, but they fear those most tempted to use their mobile phone whilst driving will be least tempted to do the Q&A in the first place.
The survey details can be found on the RACQ website. Tim Collins for 10 News First.
There might be no Sideshow Alley or Showbag Pavilion this year, but Ecca lovers are still able to get their hands on their favourite treats. Drive-through stalls serving Dagwood dogs and strawberry sundaes have popped up across Brisbane. One worker even did a lunch run today, taking 17 Dagwoods back to the office. The money raised from the sundae sales will go towards medical research at the Prince Charles Hospital Foundation. It's been a wet end to the week with heavy falls throughout parts of Queensland. Quilpie has picked up 40 millimetres in the past 24 hours. Residents in Roma, Wandoan and Proston who filmed these videos were also happy to watch the downpour earlier this morning. The Bureau says some areas will receive their monthly August average in just one day. Well, let's get more on that rain now, Josh. It was a damp end to your Queensland adventure.
Good evening, Georgie. That certainly is correct, but we're not complaining. We need the rain at the moment. It has been dry in recent times. A little bit sad that our Queensland Good To Go tour is finally drawing to a close, but we're finishing with a bang. We're coming to you live tonight from the beautiful scenic rim, and we're joined tonight by Tony Marie Bishop, who is the owner of Serebar Estate Vineyard. And first of all, Tony, I must say, stunning vineyard, absolutely amazing. Can you tell the viewers at home a little bit more about it?
Thank you. Well, it's an hour from the Gold Coast in Brisbane as well. We're a Merlot, Cabernet, Shiraz and some whites vineyard. Very proud to be local and a small family business.
Now, not only the vineyards are situated in the scenic rim, there is plenty of other things to do and see.
Oh, most certainly. It's the perfect place for hiking and bird watching. Lots and lots of local wildlife, including platypus in the creek right beside us.
Now tell me, Tony, what is your best drop from your vineyard?
Oh, well, we're best in region for our sparkling wine, but we believe that the Merlot made into rosé is, well, it's certainly the best seller for us, but we also believe it's very good drop.
Merlot, absolutely delicious, that is for sure. Might have to try some later. In terms of the weather today, it was a wet one. We saw widespread rainfall, 10 to 25 millimetres, right across parts of southeast Queensland. But of course, Georgie, I'll be back at 5 to 6 with all the weekend weather details live from the scenic rim.
We'll see you then. Thanks, Josh. Ahead, a million cases in just 20 days, India's new corona crisis. Also, tongue-tied over Thailand, Donald Trump's pronunciation gaffe, and the show Must Go On, the creative way to bring CGen to Queensland during COVID.
Is working from home
taking over your life.
Well, the Fab Four are coming to the rescue.
I'm going to pull off some magic and get their business out of the living room.
So what's Barry's working from home secret?
My gosh. I mean so much.
The Living Room, 7:30 tonight on 10.
Centrum provides multiple health benefits in just one tablet. Centrum, complete from A to Zinc.
We're working on something bigger than we've ever done before. It's bigger than this, and this, and even this. We're creating over 200,000 jobs by investing in Australia. That'll help get our super and the economy growing again. And if you're with one of these, you're a big part of it.
This is not a normal adventure race. Mountains, jungles, ocean, and it is brutal.
We can handle anything that comes, because we're in it together.
This is the closest we ever get to being superheroes.
Command hooks are designed to stay on strong, to help organise your life. And when it's time, they come off cleanly. Holds up to 3.4 kilos, stays on strong, comes off clean. Command products from 3M.
With all my favourite clothes.
The great outdoors has never looked better. And to celebrate, Mitsubishi is offering 7 years warranty and up to $1,500 worth of genuine accessories, so you'll be all set to come and see for yourself.
So, about you, what do you need to succeed? Is it help getting started or just getting a start? Is it skills that the world needs or the perfect placement at the perfect time? Is it the bravery to throw yourself right into the deep end, or a page in your global success story? Maybe you don't know what it is yet. Maybe it's time to find out.
No matter how they sleep, take comfort that Huggies newborn nappies with Huggies Dry Touch Layer quickly absorbs runny poos. And our super soft outer cover provides our best care for your newborn's delicate skin. Huggies, be comfortable in your skin.
Don't you know who I am?
Guess who?
The Masked Singer starts 7:30 Monday.
3 days to go.
Hello there. Families across the country are saving hundreds of dollars a year in interest because it seems COVID-19 has been a good time to wipe away credit card debt. According to the data, Australians have shaved off a staggering $4.2 billion since March. Credit card debt accruing interest is now just under $23 billion. According to Rate City, that's the lowest total in 15 years. During this time, almost 400,000 credit card accounts have also been closed. Meanwhile, fresh analysis by the Grattan Institute suggests the early release super scheme won't hurt the retirement of most workers. Using a 35-year-old employee on the median wage of about $60,000 who took out the full $20,000 available from their super, their retirement income would only fall by about $900 a year. Grattan researchers argue their lower super balance would be offset by larger age pension payments. To the ASX 200, it's finished weaker. The materials sector was actually the drag today. Travel travel stocks okay despite border controls. To the dollar, it's weaker, but still over 72 US cents. Two quick things before we go. There's at least one prominent economist now tipping the Reserve Bank will cut interest rates again following the RBA's updated economic forecast today. And there's a new podcast to pick apart what's going on in the finance world right now. The COVID economy is up now on 10 News First Person. Download it at 10 Speaks and have a listen over the weekend. And that's finance.
The most powerful pro-gun lobby in America is being sued by New York's Attorney General, accused of misusing millions of dollars. The organisation's leadership is accused of funneling the funds into personal accounts. It's also claimed the CEO spent $500,000 on 8 holidays to the Bahamas.
It's clear that the NRA has been failing to carry out its stated mission for many, many years, and instead has operated as a breeding ground for greed, abuse, and brazen illegality.
Letitia James has made no secret of her desire to dissolve the organisation, which donates heavily to right-wing politicians. Donald Trump has also addressed the NRA issue as he left for a rally in Ohio, saying they should move their headquarters to a friendlier state like Texas. Once in Ohio, he toured a Whirlpool factory where everything was going well until talk turned to overseas production and light bulbs.
Shifting production to Thailand. But I particularly like it because I don't look so orange. So it's very nice.
He did correct the Thailand gaffe, but it is one of several similar incidents of late. Coronavirus is now spreading even faster in one of the world's most populous nations. India reached 2 million infections in just 20 days, faster than the US and Brazil. But the government insists there's fewer cases per capita, despite allegations of deliberate underreporting. In the Philippines, authorities have locked down Manila and surrounding regions for a second time after an explosion in cases. It's on with the show for one of Queensland's favourite school events. Creative Generation almost didn't go ahead due to COVID until Network 10 decided to help transform the all-singing, all-dancing spectacular.
If there was ever a time we needed a bit of razzle-dazzle, there's no people like strong people. 2020, is it? We've seen a lot of things cancelled, but Creative Generation was not going to fall victim to COVID-19. Network 10 stepping in to take CGen from the arena to the lounge room with a special televised event to air on September 19.
I think it adds to the whole CGen experience, just to know that we could do this year.
Good to have something, a normal thing in my life, yeah.
Being on stage, it's just like, it gets me like really emotional sometimes because like I think about it and it's like, oh my God, this is my future.
Talented students from state schools across Queensland are still taking part, but with so many COVID hurdles, organisers had to be extra creative.
We have asked students across the state to upload their footage, the orchestra, the choir, the singers, the dancers.
Rehearsal groups are smaller, singers socially distanced, and every microphone is constantly sanitised.
So we had some video call rehearsals, which was amazing because some of us were on holidays and everything and we could all connect and rehearse.
It's just a credit to the teachers and the schools and of course the talent of our students right across Queensland.
For many of the kids this year, this is their first CGen experience. There is no crowds to cheer them on at the end of a routine, but as they say in this game, the show must go on.
I think we really need these positive experiences in our lives right now.
So with a 5, 6, 7, 8, let's go. Georgina Hill for 10 News First.
Stay with us. Tonight's top stories. Follow the break. Also, the easy target that sparked outrage after a senseless and deadly attack. And when life becomes a juggle, run away and join the circus.
Tonight, shedding new light on an unsolved missing
supply. Visit palmlakeresort.com.au.
I have no idea who you are.
That's a professional singer.
1,000,000%.
What the hell have we got here, man? An echidna and the queen. Is that a 5-cent piece?
The Masked Singer starts 7:30 Monday.
In the world we were living in, life was sweet. Bitter sweet. All we needed was a little help. Help to realize that another life was possible. They gave us the courage to change. To change for good. To change for goodness. Baby Bell, join the goodness.
The Nick Scali Winter Clearance is on now. Save up to 30% on a great range of selected items, floor stock and discontinued lines. The Nick Scali Winter Clearance on now.
So good to see you again, Harry.
You too, Granny.
I'm actually glad we split.
Really?
Yes. Whoever thought you could combine a supreme and pepperoni?
Nothing brings people together like a Domino's half and half. Bring it in.
Queensland, the world has been ravaged by COVID-19, with more than 18 million cases. In Australia, strong action on borders has worked well, and Queensland has one of the lowest rates in the country. But to enjoy eased restrictions and keep supporting jobs, we must take social distancing seriously, or risk undoing all our hard work. To learn more about the Queensland Economic Recovery Plan, visit this website. Authorised by the Queensland Government, Brisbane.
Nurofen's Advanced liquid capsules have a thin seam which enables fast release into the body. To sort pain out fast, use Nurofen's Advanced liquid capsules. Unleash the speed of liquid.
Outside, it's something to look at. But inside, it's a space to be. A space we fit our lives into. A space that brings us closer. That spans generations. Where we go to let go. In a Mazda, this space is 100 years in the making. And summed up in two words. Zoom, zoom.
So, about you, what do you need to succeed? Is it help getting started? Or just getting a start? Is it skills that the world needs? Or the perfect placement at the perfect time? Is it the bravery to throw yourself right into the deep end, or a page in your global success story? Maybe you don't know what it is yet. Maybe it's time to find out.
It's all happening at Kinsman right now, where you can save a bundle on your new Kinsman kitchen. Book your free design consultation today at kinsman.com.au.
Do it together this Father's Day with the right gear from Repco. Save 25% on all Repco batteries, GME and Oricom UHF products. This weekend only, in store and online. Repco, it starts with the parts.
I'm here to find the person I want to spend the rest of my life with.
Hopefully tonight I'm going to meet the girl I'm going to marry.
The Bachelor starts Wednesday.
Hello again, as we head into the weekend, some really wet conditions around the place and a multi-vehicle crash on the gateway southbound. A couple of lanes are still blocked after Old Cleveland Road through Belmont and delays are back to about Tim Galper at the moment. Reports of a crash too on the gateway heading northbound up around Deegan. Delays from Nudgee to the Bruce Highway. Still really slow conditions to be had too on Gympie Road from Kedron all the way through towards the Pine River Bridge and the Centenary Highway inbound. Slow from Darra through to Jindalee and southbound out towards Springfield. Very heavy going as well. I'm Dave Andrews. Thanks to Palm Lake Resort. Have yourself a great weekend. Stay safe on the roads and I'll check them again for you Monday.
Tonight's top stories, the countdown is on until Queensland slams the border shut to New South Wales and the ACT in a last line of defence against a devastating second wave. The Story Bridge standoff becomes an all-out stalemate as authorities try desperately to stop a planned protest that threatens to undo all our hard work. And $15 billion JobKeeper boost as the federal government overhauls eligibility criteria to help more Australians qualify for income support. RSPCA staff have been left disgusted after a plover was found with an arrow through its chest. The bird was spotted trying to fly around a paddock in Woodford on Wednesday. The flock is well known in the area and neighbours kept a close eye on the mother until RSPCA officers arrived. Despite surgery, she couldn't be saved.
Unfortunately, this is one of three other cases in the Moreton Bay Culture area that we've had over the past several months. These acts are very disgusting to us.
The plover's chicks were not harmed. Some aspiring acrobats are flipping out now that their circus school has reopened. There's classes for kids as young as three, with many hoping it's the start of a lifelong career under the big top.
If you're chasing circus superstardom, you've got to keep your skills sharp and really commit to the craft.
Well, I go to circus 3 times a week, 2 hours on Mondays, 3 hours on Tuesdays and 3 hours on Thursdays. But I also do separate training at a gymnastic place for trampolining every Wednesday and Friday for 2 hours each.
Some of the kids at the Flipside Circus School are just getting into the swing of it. Unfortunately for Eden Van, she's the smallest member of the performance team, so she spends a lot of her time being tossed around.
I don't know, it's like being thrown.
When they do the using her like a human skipping rope, I do kind of, you know, I feel for her joints. But also I think it's amazing.
The school's just reopened at North Shore in Hamilton while it waits for its permanent home to be built. More than 200 kids have already enrolled.
Once they nail a skill, you know, these guys are never satisfied. They kind of go, well, all right, I can juggle 7 knives, maybe how about 3 chainsaws? You know, they're always pushing it a little bit further.
And have a flipping fun time in the process. Joe Hill for 10 News First.
Well, it is sport time now. Jono, the Broncos have had a COVID breach.
They have. They just keep coming at the moment. Thank you. Hell of a run coming up. Alfie Langer and two other staff have been banned from tonight's game as anger grows around Wayne Bennett's breach. More next. Also, new Wallabies coach Dave Rennie's word of warning to the next generation of rugby stars. Jason Day's dream start to the year's first major, the PGA Championship.
Palm Lake Resort's new home bonus gives you $25,000 off your new home in one of their luxury over 50s lifestyle communities. Be quick, ends December 2020. Terms and conditions apply. Visit palmlakeresort.com.au.
Hollywood actor and comedian Jason Sudeikis joins us at 6:30.
I never thought I would ever meet someone that would make me feel like this.
This really seems too good to be true. Could be a wedding in the future, you never know.
Oh my God!
The grand finale, 7:30 Sunday.
Been thinking about university? Now's the time to get started. But enrolments close on the 23rd of August. Find the right study choice for you, all in one place, with Open Universities Australia. Explore online courses today.
Starbucks coffee is coming home. Full range now available in select supermarkets and online.
Everyone knows Volkswagen drivers expect a little more. Golf Comfort Line from just $31,490 drive away. Volkswagen.
Queensland, the world has been ravaged by COVID-19, with more than 18 million cases. In Australia, strong action on borders has worked well, and Queensland has one of the lowest rates in the country. But to enjoy eased restrictions and keep supporting jobs, we must take social distancing seriously or risk undoing all our hard work. To learn more about the Queensland Economic Recovery Plan, visit this website. Authorised by the Queensland Government, Brisbane.
The Nick Scali Winter Clearance is on now. Save up to 30% on a great range of selected items, floor stock and discontinued lines.
The Nick Scali Winter Clearance on now.
At UE Home Insurance, one of the things we're about is how much or how little time you spend at home. As this crisis has left a lot of us at home and not going into our normal workplaces, our houses are safer. If you're at home more now than when this crisis started, we'd like to offer you temporary premium relief. UE clients go to our website, follow the prompts, and your savings will be applied. Shopping around for home insurance, the same relief applies to you. UE, you insured.
Get your Woolies worth with thousands of prices dropped across the store, like Woolworths corned beef silverside from the meat department, now just $8 a kilo.
That's why I pick Woolies.
Anaconda's winter clear-out sale is on now. 30% off all swags by June 4-wheel drive. 30% off all furniture by Austrel and Spinifex. Shop online at anacondastores.com. Anaconda!
I can tell you who I am. Just kidding.
Don't you know who I am?
Good evening. Another NRL COVID breach, this time at a birthday bash for Alan Langer. The Broncos legend has been banned from tonight's grudge match against South Sydney. It comes as rival coaches blast Wayne Bennett for his own biosecurity breaches.
A legend in his own lunchtime. The fallout continues after Wayne Bennett was sprung breaking COVID rules while dining out at a Sydney restaurant.
He has put his team at risk, his team's ongoing participation in the competition at risk, even the ongoing competition at risk. That makes it a pretty expensive pizza, I guess.
By claiming he didn't know he was breaching the NRL strict protocols, Bennett has divided the league community.
Now, he's achieved a hell of a lot in the game. And, you know, every now and then, whether it's a player, administrator, or whoever within the game, sometimes you might make a little bit of a mistake.
At the end of the day, I think we've all got a bit of an idea of what might be right and what might not be right.
Under tough times, you find out the true character of people. They've got to make an example of it. Multi-million dollar business at stake here.
Even Wayne's son-in-law can't believe the ignorance or arrogance.
The talk about going to the kebab shop and out for other meals, you know, without any timelines added to them, is how often has the super coach been out and about? That he was confused. It doesn't wash for me.
The Roosters celebrated Mitch Orbison's 300th game in style, making it three wins on the trot with a 24-16 win over the Dragons.
Dragons just let it bounce. Tedesco gets the ball. It comes out right side for Manu.
The defending premiers can only get stronger with an incoming superstar set to join them.
I was actually on holiday in Spain and coach rang me and just said, just inquired about, you know, what's happening. And I actually jumped out of bed that night and did a little bit of stretching, and then I said, all right, let's give it a crack.
Michael Caine for 10 News First.
Jason Taumalolo is relishing the licence to roam given to him by interim North Queensland coach Josh Hannay. The Cowboys enforcer is hoping it'll increase his impact against the Titans on Sunday.
Giving me the green tick for my visa to roam, so I'm doing whatever I can every now and then to run a bit wider, but and saying that I'm not going to be the next Jonathan Thurston running out wide, throwing cutout balls all the way to a winger.
With all three Queensland clubs struggling on the bottom of the ladder, the winner can claim bragging rights as the best team in the state. A furious Chris Fagan has gone on the defensive about his team's wayward goal kicking. There's little time to fix the problem, though, with a crucial clash against the Bulldogs looming tomorrow night.
Short turnarounds between games has Chris Fagan stretched to his limit.
I think it's just the pressure on your time. There's no downtime.
And the stress is starting to show, following more questions on how he plans to fix the team's radar in front of goal.
We've only had 4 days to train, so you reckon we've done much? No. The image out there that we just kick poorly every week, because that's not true. You lot have probably talked about it more than what we have, to be honest. We've got to get on with the game of footy.
The Bulldogs haven't spent long analysing it either.
We've got a good plan for any opposition's forward line. I'd imagine McStay will come back into the team, and they've got, you know, some powerful contested marking players.
The key tall won't be the only change down forward, with Cam Rayner not back until at least round 14.
That creates opportunities for other people. Or, you know, Cal Archie went forward last week in the second half and actually looked pretty good up there. So we'll see how we go replacing him.
Isaac Rankin looked pretty good last night against St Kilda too. Not only were the Mark of the Year contender, but also a bit of magic to give the Suns a late sniff.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
But Dan Butler's bag proved just enough to bump the Lions out of second spot for now.
For goal number four, magnificent.
As another loss sees Gold Coast slip further down the ladder.
I'm starting to see some synergy, but you know, we'd love to have 4 points to show for it.
Josh McLean for 10 News First.
New Wallabies coach Dave Rennie concedes rugby can't match the dollars thrown at Australia's next generation of talent like rival codes. After quarantine in both Auckland and Sydney, Rennie will base himself on the Gold Coast. He admits RA's financial situation means the game will have to offer other incentives to rising stars like Joseph Suwali.
Now they're pretty aggressive, a lot of elite scouts, and they're getting into these kids when they're 14 and 15 and so on. So, yeah, we've just got to make sure that we're keeping in contact and, like I say, we're part of those conversations.
He's retired from the Wallabies, but Test veteran Will Genia will strap on the boots for Jeeps in the Brisbane competition this weekend as he makes a cameo with his Japanese league in lockdown. Jason Day says deep heat has a big part to play in his hot start to the PGA Championship. The 2015 winner is at 5-under after the first round, tied with American Brendan Todd. Defending champion Brooks Koepka is breathing down their necks, while Tiger Woods and Adam Scott are also pleased with their starts in the year's first major.
Down under the clouds, an Australian made the best start to the PGA Championship. Jason Day stuck to the short grass, avoiding penal rough at TPC Harding Park. He's found an answer to his back troubles for the time being.
Pretty much lather up in deep heat and I go out, you know, I mean, I try and burn the skin off my back, to be honest. I feel pretty good.
Day's 65 was one of only four bogey-free rounds. He's in a good frame of mind, nothing like 2 months ago when he was questioning why he bothered with golf.
Every day I'm excited to go back to the golf course and play, whereas before I was struggling to get up and going, oh, do I want to, you know, kind of put myself through this again?
Adam Scott is the only other Australian in red figures. He's been laying low in Queensland since March, but no rust has taken hold.
And yes!
2-under for the former Masters champion. It's a major, so Brooks Koepka has his A-game. Aiming to be the first player since Walter Hagen in the 1920s to win the PGA Championship 3 years in a row, he's at 4-under par. Tiger Woods played early, meaning more than 24 hours rest before his second round, and he's only 3 from the lead.
Nice recovery, gave him a chance to make a birdie.
Bryson DeChambeau's mission to be a heavyweight of golf claimed a casualty.
And I was like that, and just to pick up my tee and it... like that.
Brendan Todd, who was a year ago ranked 795 in the world, pulled level with Day not long before the sun set on San Francisco. Bence Hamerley for 10 News First.
Georgie, that's all for now. See you after six.
Thank you, Jono. Will the rain clear for the weekend? Josh has all your weather details live from Sarabar after the break.
Could a new podcast help solve a missing persons case? 6:30.
Inside an animated film.
That was incredible. I'm having the time of my life, baby.
The Masked Singer starts 7:30 Monday.
Not long now. Nearly there. Jeez, I've missed this.
Rediscover the road with Kluger, now in Run Out. Get in while stocks last. Oh, what a feeling. Toyota.
At Harvey Norman, get 15% off Microsoft Surface Pro 7, Pro X and Laptop 3. Like this Microsoft Surface Pro 7 with an Intel Core i5 processor. Now $1,274. This Surface Pro X, the ultimate in mobility. Now only $1,444. That's 15% off. Or this Surface Laptop 3, offering style and speed. $1,698, save 15%. Hurry, 15% off Microsoft Surface Pro 7, Pro X and Laptop 3 ends Monday at Harvey Norman.
Go! Since I was a kid, I knew I wanted a job that would help me empower my people. Now I'm studying a Law and Business double degree at QUT. My heart is set on becoming a human rights lawyer, and QUT is helping me get there.
Venue Mode has officially landed, which means exclusive promotions and markets at your local every time the green light is on. Download your new Tab app and get the home ground advantage here on Earth. Tab, long may we play.
At Spotlight, save more at our Homemaker Sale with 50% off Fowood Venetian blinds, 40% off all Righty room darkening curtains, 40% off made-to-measure indoor blinds, so you can open it, roll it and keep it warm for less. Sale on now. At Spotlight, it's what you make it.
Our scheme goes through a lot, day by day. Time to reward it. Discover Nivea Body Lotion with Deep Moisture Serum for 48-hour deep moisture you can feel and see.
Welcome to the Jowna Dairy Farm. We're a 100% Australian-owned family dairy that's been making yoghurt the authentic way, in the pot, for over 60 years. Jowna Pot Set Yoghurt. If only everything was so pure.
The Art of Living sale is on now. For a limited time, save on the best in Australian indoor and outdoor design. So why buy ordinary furniture when you can come home to King Furniture? Sale on now.
Don't you know who I am?
Guess who?
The Masked Singer starts 7:30 Monday.
3 days to go.
Tonight's weather report is brought to you by Queensland, where you're good to go. Start planning at queensland.com because it's time to explore like never before.
Let's get another weather check with Josh, and it looks like a lovely spot to end the week.
Good evening, Georgie. That is correct. It doesn't get much better than this. Just an hour's drive south of Bris Vegas, you end up in the scenic rim. It's absolutely stunning. We got a bit of rainfall today, but we had this low cloud coming through the valley, and it just looked absolutely majestic at around about 3 o'clock this afternoon. But we'll get to the weather in just a moment. Of course, we are back live here at the scenic rim, and we're joined tonight by Robin and Paul Lee from Greenlee Farm and Cottages. First of all, Robin, tell us a little bit about the property and especially the cottages.
Josh, well, we've actually lived out here for 25 years, but the cottages have only been operational for 4 years. We have four cottages, three of them are one bedroom, and the fourth one is a two bedroom, but it's accessible as well. So that means that people with special needs can certainly use that cottage.
And I was on your property today. Absolutely fantastic. A great spot for a couple of days off, maybe a weekend away. But there's not only the cottages here, there's plenty to see and do right across the scenic rim.
Absolutely. I mean, having said that, some people just love to come here and relax, you know, wandering around. But we're very close to bushwalking. We've also got the wineries, like where we are now, and other wineries in the area. And of course, there's just nature all around us. We have bird life, wildlife, and the flowers at the moment are just amazing.
Yeah, it's absolutely stunning currently in the scenic rim, that is for sure. Now, we mentioned the cottages. Let's talk about the farming side of things. You'll see this beautiful produce here, the macadamias, of course, grown right here on Greenlee Farm. And Paul, tell us a little bit about the process.
Well, we planted these over 20 years ago now, so they're well-matured trees. Only a small orchard. Originally, we never intended to live off them, but things evolved and we've gone a long way down the track now, and we do the whole paddock to plate thing. So in saying that, next week we've got a macadamia tour on. Anybody that's interested can come down to Greenlee Farm on Friday. I think that's the Eco Holiday, Friday the 14th.
Sure is, yep.
And we'll be putting on four tours that day. It's a ticketed event, so people will be able to go to scenicrim.com and book their tickets.
Sounds absolutely fantastic. I advise you do so. Queensland, you are good to go. And come down to the Scenic Rim. You will not be disappointed. You can also book your next Queensland adventure at queensland.com as we check the weather at your place and dive into the satellite tonight. And we do have a frontal system that is tracking across areas of southeastern Australia, driving widespread rain across the region, embedded thunderstorms as well. As we move to the synoptic chart, a strong upper-level low over South Australia, Northern Territory border will will track to the southeast over the coming few days, with an associated cold front sweeping eastwards across Queensland. We're experiencing that at the moment. The trough system will, however, move off the coast as we get through tomorrow, with cooler and dry air spreading over most of the state as a new ridge develops over central parts of Queensland. On the rain chart, and showers with the chance of a storm will persist over eastern districts before the clearance of that trough tomorrow. A high chance of showers about the tropical coast and a slight to medium chance of showers up around areas of the peninsula. Other areas should remain dry. Interstate, and showers will start to ease for Sydney Saturday. Melbourne, showers and wind easing through the day as well. Adelaide, a shower or two, and Perth will be dry with partly cloudy skies. For Queensland, the tropics will have the chance of seeing some shower activity tomorrow, so showers for Cairns and partly cloudy for Townsville. Mackay, a possible shower. Rocky will be overcast tomorrow. Bundaberg and Gympie, just a shower or two. For the southeast, a partly cloudy day on the way. The medium chance of showers most likely in the morning and afternoon. The chance of a thunderstorm in the afternoon and evening. Overnight temperatures falling to between 11 and 15 degrees, with daytime temperatures reaching the low to mid-20s. Out on the bay, we've got winds. They'll be north to northwesterly at around about 10 knots and the seas below 1 metre. For Brisbane City, a shower or two tomorrow, clearing through the day. I don't think we'll see huge amounts of rain into the gauges. If you make any plans, probably make them a little bit later in the day. But Sunday, check this out, looking very nice indeed. Sunny skies on the way, partly cloudy on Monday, mostly sunny as we roll into Tuesday. For Ipswich, a shower or two for Saturday, sunny skies on Sunday, partly cloudy on Monday, and mostly sunny as we roll into another Tuesday. Well, what a week it's been. All the way from Bundaberg to Fraser Island to the Sunshine Coast, hinterland, the Gold Coast, the scenic rim this evening, which has been absolutely fantastic. Make sure you come and visit the Greenleaf Farm and Cottages. Robin and Paul will be waiting for you. That is for sure. And don't forget, you can book at queensland.com. We'll have more weather coming up shortly.
Countdown to shutdown, peak hour at our border, ahead of a complete shutdown to the rest of the East Coast. We're live with what you need to know. Urgent talks underway to end the Story Bridge stalemate and avoid a mass protest. And a $15 billion boost to JobKeeper, along with an eligibility overhaul to give more people access to income support. Time is ticking for people to return to Queensland as the border lockdown looms large. John Paul Gonzo joins us now from Coolangatta. JP, there are major delays at checkpoints tonight.
Significant disruption, Georgie. This checkpoint is one of the better ones here at Coolangatta. Traffic is flowing relatively freely. It's a very different story on the M1. There is a 7 kilometre queue of cars, people trying to get back into Queensland. They have been waiting for more than an hour, and those delays are only going to grow. The Gold Coast Highway is also experiencing delays. It is going to get worse before it gets better. The new pass that border residents require still isn't available online, meaning they cannot apply for it yet. Police say if it isn't ready by the 1 a.m. deadline, officers will have to pull people over on the side of the road to verify their identity and address. Of course, that border pass for border community residents incorporates 72 postcodes on either side. It means they can cross for any reason at any time, but they will still be subject to strict rules.
They can only come into the adjacent communities on the other side of the border. They can't go through the rest of Queensland.
We expect the road borders in particular to be quite problematic over the weekend, and please work with us.
The wet weather and slippery roads are causing more chaos tonight. Police are pleading for drivers to have some patience. This border process is going to get harder before it gets easier. Georgie.
Thank you, John Paul. Live there at Coolangatta. Urgent negotiations are right now underway between police and the organisers of tomorrow's protest on the Story Bridge. Refugee advocates delivered an ultimatum to avoid the planned action, but as Claire Barnes reports, authorities are standing firm.
The state's chief health officer has issued a last-minute plea to protesters not to go ahead with tomorrow's action. Refugee advocates are threatening to shut down the Story Bridge in response to the ongoing detention of asylum seekers in a Kangaroo Point hotel. Today, police again warned those pushing ahead with the rally will be stopped.
They will not be permitted to block the Bradfield Highway, the Story Bridge. We will take action, and if people commit offences, they can expect to be arrested.
The planned protest comes at a critical time for Queensland, with 5 cases now linked to the Logan women who travelled to Melbourne. Since then, almost 120,000 people have been tested.
To do all of that and potentially have it undone because people breach those requirements this weekend would be an awful thing to see.
The demonstrators have their own demands. If refugees are given more freedoms, they won't gather.
I believe that social distancing and safety requirements will be followed. I would say that there is a football game just on down the road that will be on at the same time, where 10,000 people will be assembling, and will be a similar COVID risk there.
Authorities say if there are huge crowds, it may delay the easing of restrictions for nursing homes.
That's what's at stake here, whether hundreds of Queenslanders can have their families visit them in their nursing homes or not.
The Chief Health Officer hopes to make a decision about aged care facilities by early next week.
Major changes have been announced to the JobKeeper package as the federal government scrambles to help Victoria stay afloat. It comes just weeks after the Treasurer announced payments would be scaled back from the end of September. Stella Todorovic has the details.
As Victorian businesses shut and the state's stage 4 lockdown rattles the national economy, the government has announced a further $15 billion will be added to the JobKeeper scheme.
The single largest economic support package that any Australian government has ever undertaken.
There will be 2 major changes to the eligibility criteria. From September 28, businesses will only need to show a downturn for the September quarter compared to a similar period in 2019. And if you're applying for the JobKeeper from January, you'll only need to show a fall in turnover for the December quarter. And employees eligible must be employed as of July 1st this year. Treasury indicates 4 million Australians will be on JobKeeper during the September quarter. Of those, 1.3 million will be in Victoria.
That's nearly half the private sector workforce in Victoria.
The key test for the Morrison government is whether they can prevent those unemployment queues being too long.
It's estimated 400,000 more Australians will lose their jobs between now and Christmas. This has prompted the Reserve Bank to warn the government without continued economic help, Australia will be facing a long-term unemployment crisis.
JobKeeper has been a lifeline to people's livelihoods. It's been a lifeline to businesses.
The cost of JobKeeper will now hit $101 billion. And in an effort to keep the scheme going as long as possible, the $1,500 fortnightly payment will be scaled back to $1,200 from the end of September.
Victoria has recorded another 450 cases of coronavirus and 11 deaths, 7 of them linked to the aged care outbreak. It comes as the government moves to alleviate the uncertainty facing Year 12 students.
In lockdown and trying to study, 2020 has thrown all sorts of challenges at Victorian students.
We've sort of just been able to sort of keep on driving through, keep on studying without really knowing that end goal.
But now, some relief. All Year 12 students trying to complete their final year will be given special consideration.
So now, students will go into their VCE exams with the confidence knowing that they will not be disadvantaged as a result of COVID-19.
Teachers will assess students on how the pandemic has affected their studying abilities and their results.
And we're asking teachers, where do you rank your students right now? And where would they have been had it not been for COVID-19 and why?
Victoria recorded 450 new coronavirus cases today and 11 deaths, 7 of them linked to aged care. The state has more than 7,600 active cases. 607 people are in hospital. 41 of those are in ICU.
Having seen stabilisation in numbers, that's a positive.
Dozens of ADF teams are outdoor knocking every positive COVID-19 case to make sure they're isolating at home. Yesterday, they knocked on 1,150 doors, but 150 people they were checking on couldn't be found. Victoria Police is now investigating 500 cases of people who weren't home.
They weren't where we door knocked them, when we door knocked them.
Victoria Police, not me, Victoria Police will determine whether they've done the right or the wrong thing.
Victoria has 1,548 active cases linked to its aged care crisis. One of the outbreaks was at St Basil's, but a backup workforce brought in to help deal with the situation were captured fraternising together at their hotel accommodation in the early hours of July 28. The revelation is further insult to the families of the home's residents.
Those sort of stories just make us get us really angry. I'd like to question the government in what sort of criteria did they meet that contract requirement? What sort of training have they got? Because obviously all this is just another hotel quarantine disaster.
All residents from the home have been sent to hospitals and it has become the subject of a coronial inquiry. Candace Wyatt for 10 News First.
Violent protests have erupted on the streets of Beirut just days after more than 150 people were killed in a massive explosion. Crowds have tried to break into Parliament and police have been attacked.
Pain and loss have now descended into anger and violence. Protesters trying to kick down the gates to Parliament, demanding the government pick up the pieces, both of their city and the political system. Years of corruption and inaction, now symbolised by the rubble and destruction that were people's homes and businesses. And now growing evidence officials knew the risks, yet refused to do anything. French President Emmanuel Macron was in Beirut today vowing to help his country's former colony. The crowd hangs on his every word, given there's so little faith in their own government.
La confiance et l'espoir.
Macron said an international inquiry into the blast is needed, but no politician or pledge of help can ease the pain as the funerals start for the more than 150 killed or at bedside vigils for the survivors.
I just want to live and stay in a place where there's no politics, there's no guns, there's no religion.
Australian family, the Mooses, were at home when the blast wave hit.
You can see the blood on the floor from the children.
The kids escaped serious injury but have recurring nightmares. And with no way out of Beirut, many Australian families are asking our government for help.
Despite some governments expatriating their citizens, the Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade has said because of COVID-19, they won't be sending any planes to Beirut. Instead, they suggest Australians book commercial flights home, even though there aren't any available for weeks.
So for now, the nightmare continues. Antoinette Latouf for 10 News First.
Heart-stopping vision has been released of the moment police were confronted with a fiery truck crash and an injured driver unable to move. Police and witnesses stopped on the Bruce Highway near Miriamvale on Wednesday night and desperately raced towards the scene. The smash between three trucks and a ute sparked a 50-metre firewall.
We need to get further away from this truck. Mate, we're going to have to move you, OK?
Police have praised the actions of passing motorists who stopped to help. The two truckies remain in hospital. Coming up, putting Ipswich motorists in the driver's seat of a high-tech test. Also, why this traffic jam was one most people wouldn't have minded. And in sport, the Broncos legend forced into quarantine after another COVID bubble breach.
Why thousands of Victorians will be screaming in unison tonight. Plus, we catch up with the hilarious Ross Noble. See you at 6:30.
Not till after dinner.
There's a glass and a half in everyone.
Get your Woolies worth with Everyday Rewards for the chance to win 1 million points every day for 7 days. Simply shop and scan your card at Woolworths or other participating stores.
That's why I pick Woolies.
This is not a normal adventure race.
Mountains, jungles, ocean, and it is brutal.
We can handle anything that comes because we're in it together.
This is the closest we ever get to being superheroes.
Centrum provides multiple health benefits in just one tablet. Centrum, complete from A to Zinc.
The world needs more cooks. Because with a hot pan and a little love pack, a cook can tame the wild, feed the hungry, and transform nothing into everything. Where there are cooks, there is hope.
If you're worried about your actions or relationship, contact Men's Line for free, confidential advice and counselling, online and by phone 24/7. There's no place for abuse or domestic violence. Help is here. Authorised by the Australian Government, Canberra.
At Mercedes-Benz, we stand for the best or nothing. But right now, we believe the best is nothing. So that's exactly what we're offering. Nothing to overthink. Nothing to doubt. Nothing to pay up front. And no repayments for up to 3 months. They're on us. We're giving you our best deal of all. Nothing. Enjoy nothing at your Mercedes-Benz retailer today.
At Drake Supermarkets, we've got ingredients for cool days with Campbell's Country Ladle or Chunky Soup, half price. And for work days with Golden Crumpet 6-pack, also half price. Drake Supermarkets.
Ingredients for every day.
Is working from home taking over your life?
Well, the Fab Four are coming to the rescue.
I'm going to pull off some magic and get their business out of the living room.
So what's Barry's working from home secret?
My gosh. I mean so much.
The Living Room, 7:30 tonight on 10.
Ipswich motorists are being invited to take part in a test to develop driver assistance technology. The trial aims to investigate just how much the modern tools could enhance the daily driving experience.
It's complicated technology on the road toward a very simple objective.
How vehicles might be able to be driven more safely so we can stop some of the crashes that we see on roads today.
Modern vehicles can sense objects around them, warn drivers and monitor congestion. How far that technology advances will depend on field testing.
Everybody in Australia is looking very closely at what we're doing here because this has to be a national approach.
Starting today and conducted over the next 9 months, Ipswich will be a testing zone.
We have a sort of a very older part of it, you know, of Ipswich with traditional sort of one-way streets and intersections, but we also have newer suburbs with sort of, you know, the narrow, windy streets.
27 intersections across the region are fitted with communications equipment that can talk to the vehicle and tell a driver what's happening around them, even if they can't see it. While the most important safety mechanism in any moving vehicle will always be the person behind the wheel, it's hoped the trial will help manufacturers tailor the alert system for Australian drivers.
Any of this technology that will assist the driver to be more cautionary around intersections or other roadworks will certainly be a benefit.
By 2025, this will be technology they expect to be in vehicles entering the Australian market.
Those wishing to find out if they're eligible to take part will find more information at this website. Chris Campy for 10 News First.
Now to the traffic jam that was sparked by a rather special delivery, I should say. An expectant mum was headed to hospital in labour, but her baby girl just couldn't wait.
Lexia Price is a bona fide traffic stopper. And if you were stuck in kilometres of traffic crawling along the M4 at Prospect last night, you'll certainly agree.
It's causing very heavy traffic tracking back through to Eastern Creek.
Around 4:45 yesterday evening, her parents, David and Angela, were rushing down the motorway just minutes from Blacktown Hospital. But young Lexi couldn't wait any longer.
On the freeway, she said she had to push, so I sped up. Then she said she could feel the head, so I pulled over.
In the breakdown lane, David frantically called 000, but Angela was already in the thick of it.
Initially, he didn't say anything. He just said, I'm on the M4 near Blacktown. And then everything kind of went a little bit quiet, so I was a bit impatient, going, come on, are you there? Are you listening?
Exactly what happened. We've just delivered the baby.
Incredibly, David had done some pre-reading from an SAS survival handbook he'd been given as a teen, with one page of instructions about emergency births.
I pulled this book out just to stare Angie a bit about, you know, how I've read this, I can do it if we have to, and yeah, lucky.
There you go. Why do you need an obstetrician? Because I don't want to ever do that again.
Little Lexi and Mum are both doing well, just a minor speed bump on the long road ahead. Sydney Pete for 10 News First.
Good on him. I can't believe that was in an SAS handbook.
Always read the baby book.
Yeah, that's right. Be prepared. Well, Jono's back now with another look at sport.
Thank you, Georgie. Hello again. Broncos legend Alan Langer and two other club staff have each been fined $5,000 and will miss tonight's grudge match against South Sydney for a birthday bash COVID breach, while Wayne Bennett's copped a $20,000 fine after he was caught dining at a Sydney restaurant. The Rabbitohs coach claimed he didn't know he was breaching the NRL strict protocols.
He has put his team at risk, his team's ongoing participation in the competition at risk, even the ongoing competition at risk. That makes it a pretty expensive pizza.
Under tough times, you find out the true character of people. They've got to make an example of it. Multi-million dollar business at stake here.
Bennett has begun 14 days in isolation. Chris Fagan refuses to admit his Lions have a goal-kicking problem. The club averages more behinds than any other team in the competition and is ranked last for accuracy. But Fagan's confident the trend won't continue against the Bulldogs tomorrow night.
You know, I will say about the accuracy, yeah, we're 18th, but that's on the back of two really poor games, and we shouldn't sort of carry on like the club kicks 15 more points than goals each week.
Brisbane's recent record against the Dogs isn't a good one, losing five of their last six meetings. Queenslander Jason Day shares the lead of the year's first major, shooting 5-under in the opening round of the PGA Championship. Defending champion Brooks Koepka is only one shot behind. Day produced one of only four bogey-free rounds at TPC Harding Park in San Francisco. He's feeling confident after three top 10 finishes in a row and rediscovering his love of the game.
Every day I'm excited to go back to the golf course and play, whereas before I was struggling to get up and going, oh, do I want to, you know, kind of put myself through this again.
Adam Scott showed next to no rust in his first tournament since March. He's level with Tiger Woods at 2-under. It would be great to see another Aussie win a major, Georgie.
It would, wouldn't it? That looked like a beautiful course too.
Yeah, sensational.
Thank you, Jono. Stay with us. Josh has your weekend weather details live from Sarabar after the break.
Get ready for the biggest week of 2020 on 10.
Sunday, who will find love in the Bachelor in Paradise finale?
I love it!
Monday, the world's craziest show is back.
Who's underneath that mask?
Wednesday, Lockie's quest for love begins.
Please like me.
The biggest week of 2020
starts Sunday on 10.
Tired of cleansers that leave skin dull? The power of micellar with the glow of rosewater. New Garnier Micellar Rosewater Cleanser. Micelles lift dirt like a magnet. In one swipe removes makeup and reveals the glow. New Micellar Rosewater by Garnier. Naturally.
What's for dinner?
What's for dinner?
What's for dinner?
What could be easier than over 80 Coles quick and simple dinner ideas?
What do you reckon?
Sounds good.
All made with 5 ingredients or less and ready in 30 minutes or less.
Fantastic.
There's a meal for everyone.
Let's eat.
Like our easy chicken burgers with apple and slaw. Just $5 per serve. Discover all the recipes at coles.com.au.
We'll have this one again.
What's for dinner?
My favourite.
Good things, great value at Coles.
Not long now. Jeez, I've missed this.
Rediscover the road with Kluger, now in Run Out. Get in while stocks last. Oh, what a feeling. Toyota.
This Saturday, place a fixed odds win bet on all races at Doomben, Rosehill and Flemington in venue with your Tab app. And if your horse runs second, third, fourth or fifth, get a bonus bet back up to $50. Tab. Long may we play.
The 100% Aussie beef in Macca's Burgers comes from farms like David's in Queensland.
My family supplies 100% Aussie beef to McDonald's.
Thanks, David. Get into Macca's for hot, juicy, tasty burgers today.
No matter how you care for their skin, take comfort that new Huggies Ultimate is our best care for skin. Now with our first ever plant-derived liner wrap made from renewable sources. Huggies. Be comfortable in your skin.
And there is only one...
I'm alive! Just kidding. I'm dead inside, emotionally. But that's neither here nor there. There's still only one cure for hungry, thirsty, and that's oak. With its full strength and full taste, it's full on! Oh, oak. Kill hungry, thirsty, dead.
South Australia. You have to see it to believe it. And you can, thanks to 20% off South Australia holiday packages on Webjet. At Coles, we believe the love of reading begins with a good book. So we've teamed up with Andy Griffiths and Terry Denton, creators of the inspiring, amazing and best-selling Treehouse series, to bring you Coles Little Treehouse. There are 24 stories and activities to bring the magic of storytelling and kids' imaginations to life. And you can get a free little book with every $30 you spend at Coles and Coles Express. Coles, good things, great value.
Wow. Now that smells amazing.
You do make the best roast pork, Mum.
We love your cackle, Nana.
It's almost ready.
Riverview Farms pork roast. Perfectly cooked for your family, just like Nana made it every time.
Up next, the government backflips on tougher JobKeeper rules, but for how long? How a baffling missing persons case could be one step closer to being solved. Tommy catches up with Hollywood actor and comedian Jason Sudeikis, and we'll end the week on a high when we hunker down in Ross Noble's COVID bunker. The project next.
Time for a final weather check, Josh. The rain hasn't dampened your wonderful week away.
No, that's right, Georgie. It's been an absolutely fantastic week. We've seen some incredible places and met just some wonderful people. Of course, we kicked off in Bundaberg, went down through Fraser Island, the Sunshine Coast hinterland, the Gold Coast yesterday, and we've ended up in the scenic rim this evening. Of course, it's no secret, it is tough times at the moment for our tourist operators. So many might be asking at home, what can I do? Well, it's pretty simple. What you can do is jump onto queensland.com and book your next Queensland adventure. We know the borders have been shut once again, so it's up to us now. Queenslanders out there, book your next Queensland holiday as soon as you can, because these guys do need your help. We know how important tourism is across our fantastic state. So that website again, queensland.com, as we check the weather at your place for the final time this Friday evening and dive into the satellite once again. And we do have a frontal system moving across parts of southeastern Australia, and it's bringing some widespread rain across the region. An upper trough is producing mid-level cloud and isolated thunderstorms over central parts of Queensland. On the synoptic chart, a strong upper-level low over the over South Australia. The Northern Territory border will track to the southeast over the coming days, with an associated cold front sweeping eastwards across Queensland at the moment. That trough system will move offshore tomorrow and alleviate the showers, but they still will persist over eastern districts before the clearance of the trough. A high chance of showers about the tropical coast as well. For the tropics, as mentioned, the chance of seeing some shower activity tomorrow. Showers for Cairns and partly cloudy for Townsville. Mackay just a possible shower. Rocky will be cloudy. Bundaberg and Gympie a shower or two. Into the southeast we roll. Partly cloudy. The medium chance of showers most likely in the morning and afternoon. The chance of a thunderstorm in the afternoon and evening as well. Overnight temperatures falling to between 11 and 15 degrees. Daytime temperatures reaching the low to mid 20s. For Brisbane City, we're looking at a shower or two for tomorrow. I think you'll find it'll start to clear through the day. As I mentioned earlier tonight, if you are making plans tomorrow, probably make them later in the afternoon. But the good news is, as we track through Sunday, it's looking absolutely fantastic with sunny skies. Partly cloudy on Monday, mostly sunny as we roll into Tuesday. For Ipswich, a shower or two for Saturday, sunny skies on Sunday, partly cloudy on Monday and mostly sunny on Tuesday. For the Gold Coast, we're looking at a shower or two tomorrow, sunny skies to finish the weekend, partly cloudy Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday next week. For the Sunshine Coast, a shower or two tomorrow, nice and sunny on Sunday, mostly sunny Monday and Tuesday, and partly cloudy on Wednesday. Well, I know you're probably sick of me saying it, but I'm going to say it again. Queensland, you are good to go. Make sure you jump onto queensland.com and book your next Queensland holiday. Our tourist operators need your help. And why wouldn't you, Georgie? We've seen all these fantastic places this week. They have been absolutely tremendous. And of course, it is Friday evening. Have a great weekend. I'll see you on Monday.
Thank you, Joshua. We do live in an incredible state. Well, that is 10 News First for now. Have a great weekend. We'll see you Monday. Good night.
tonight, the government...